Hi friends, a lot of people have been telling me that I am messing with India's richest builder and also India's richest politician, and so I should get protection. And so you see, I am wearing this helmet. The only protection I can afford is a bicycle helmet. And so if I feel that I am at risk, I'm going to start wearing this bicycle helmet. But in the meanwhile, guys, I'm going to put it away, because being defensive all the time, being scared all the time, really sucks. I'm not very good at it. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to go around like this with my bald head. If someone wants to take me out, he's welcome to do that. Mangal Prabhat Lodha. According to newspaper reports in November 2018, is India's richest builder. According to this GROHE Hurun India Real Estate Rich List, Mangal Prabhat Lodha is, his personal net worth is estimated at $3.8 billion. I did some calculations. It works out to 26,000 crore rupees. My math isn't very good, so I hope I'm right on this. Mangal Prabhat Lodha is estimated to be worth 26,000 crore rupees. And please correct me if my math is wrong. So he is India's richest builder. And I suspect he is India's richest politician also. Someone tell me if there is a politician who is worth more than 26,000 crore rupees. So Mangal Prabhat Lodha, according to his Wikipedia page, which looks a lot like it's been drafted by someone who is quite close to Lodha. According to his Wikipedia page, he has been BJP MLA for 24 years, that is since 1995. He has enjoyed 5 consecutive terms from Malabar Hill constituency as an MLA. So in 24 years, he has earned, this politician has earned 26,000 crores. That's one way of looking at it. I'm just trying to understand 26,000 crores. I mean, I have never seen even 1 crore rupees altogether. Like, I have never seen a check of 1 crore rupees ever. I have never seen cash of 1 crore rupees ever in my life. Okay? So, I'm just trying to figure out this thing about 26,000 crore rupees. I'm calculating it in my mind. It's a crazy number. In 24 years of being a politician, if he has earned 26,000 crore rupees, then that means that he has earned more than 1,000 crores per every year of being a politician. But maybe he is not earning money being a politician, right? It's wrong to say that every politician makes money by being a politician. So maybe he hasn't earned any money being a politician. Maybe he's only spending some of his money as a politician. He's doing good works, charitable works, and so on. Maybe. So then we come to the alternative thing, which is he has earned all this money, 26,000 crore rupees, as a builder. Now, Mangal Prabhat Lodha has been a builder for about 35 years or so. That is since 1985, around that time. He's been around till since around then. So, it's reasonable to assume that he has made this 26,000 crore rupees from the building industry over 35 years, which averages to around 750 crore rupees per year. 750 crore rupees per year. That's the kind of average. Could he have earned 750 crore rupees per year? Wow, amazing. That's some amazing business. Now, oh, by the way, there are some people who say that he kind of inherited the wealth from somewhere. I'm not going to say from where, but like just somebody died and left him a huge pot of wealth. I'm not saying that, but people say that. It's said. You know, like somebody just died from weird reasons and left a big secret stash of money to Lodha. Could be. I'm not saying that. It could be. I don't know. You don't know. Nobody knows. But strange things happen in this world. So that could be another explanation for the 750 crore rupees per year over 35 years. Okay. That's an awesome number. Now, nobody is asking questions. People don't like asking questions. People like buying houses. People like paying tokens. People like swiping their cards and saying, oh, well, Lodha, great company, big brand. You know, they don't ask questions. You shouldn't ask questions from a builder. I agree. You shouldn't ask questions of a builder. He's a private guy. He's a private entity. But shouldn't the voting public ask questions to their elected representative Mangal Prabhat Lodha? Shouldn't the voting public be asking questions to a politician who's been a politician for 24 years? I think that's a lot longer than some of the listeners have been alive. I mean, guys who listen to my videos are, some of them are in college age, which means 3 years more than, he has been a politician for 3 or 4 years or 5 years more than a college graduate was even alive, was even before he was born, right? So shouldn't the voting public of India be asking their elected representative or voting public of Mumbai, Malabar Hill constituency, at least? Shouldn't they be asking their elected representative and lawmaker, Mr. Mangal Prabhat Lodha, the patron saint of Lodha Group, the saintly figure, the saintly renounced figure, who rarely says a word in mundane matters of the building, this thing, shouldn't they be asking him to openly declare his personal wealth along with the wealth of his companies, the Lodha Group, now renamed as Macrotech? And don't you think they should be asking Lodha whether his wealth is growing or shrinking every year? You know, I think people should be asking. You know why? Because Mangal Prabhat Lodha is an MLA, a member of Legislative Assembly of the ruling party. So he's a public representative. He has direct access to Mantralaya. He has direct access to the Chief Minister. Probably even to the Prime Minister. He is Vice President of the Maharashtra BJP. Of BJP in Maharashtra, he's the vice president. And we all know that parties need money to function. So I'm hoping that Mangal Prabhat Lodha has been generous with BJP. But along with such generosity comes possibility of quid pro quo, right? So here's Mangal Prabhat Lodha, India's richest politician, possibly, I don't know, he's probably India's richest politician. And he's got direct access to Prime Minister Modi and direct access to Chief Minister Fadnavis and probably direct access to the Municipal Commissioner who gives building permissions and direct access to the Metropolitan Commissioner of MMRDA, the boss of MMRDA. He's got direct access to the decision makers. He's an insider to the corridor of powers, of corridors of power, right? He's got direct access. So, is it his duty to be transparent and accountable and available to the public? Don't you think he should be there answering a press conference? Don't you think he should be out there saying, hey, listen, this idiot called Krishna Raj Rao is making baseless allegations against me and saying that I have built a highly hazardous project in New Cuffe Parade, and he says that, you know, and he comes out there and says that, Krishna Raj Rao, I challenge you, come to the Indian Merchants Chamber and sit down and we'll have a public debate on this. Don't you think a politician should be doing that? India's richest politician. I don't know about most powerful. I don't know. Maybe he is, because money buys a lot of power. Money buys a lot of influence. But India's richest politician, that's what I think he is. 26,000 crores. Don't you think it is his duty to be accountable and transparent and available to the public? And don't you think it is our right as the public to ask the right questions to him? Now, what are the right questions? I'll give you an example of what are the right questions. Here is a question the public should be asking. It should be asking, and I'm referring specifically to the flat buyers. They should be asking, Mr. Mangal Prabhat Lodha, how much of your personal fortune of hundreds of crores, no, 26,000 crores, how much of it have you earned by forfeiting, that is taking away the booking amount, the token amount, or even more, paid by flat buyers? Like, out of 26,000 crores, is it 10 crores? Is it 20 crores? Is it 50 crores? Is it 100 crores? How much of this has come from token amounts forfeited by flat buyers? Ordinary middle class people, you know, couples who buy these 45, 50 lakh rupee flats at Palava, or maybe more rich people who buy 8 crore rupee flats at New Cuffe Parade. You know, when they forfeit big, right? 50, if, you know, they might have forfeited 50 lakhs, 60 lakhs. Or someone who has forfeited even bigger amounts by a flat buyer of, say, World One. So, how much of your 26,000 crores, Mr. Lodha, is coming out of forfeited amounts? Is it? Let's put a figure on it. Come on. You got accounts, right? You got books of accounts. You got an office full of chartered accountants who will be, I'm sure, who are doing a brilliant job of keeping track of all your earnings. So can we have a breakup, please, of how much is coming from the forfeited amounts? Secondly, you know, this is the reason I'm asking this, and the reason public should be asking this is, see, when you take away 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 50 lakhs, 1 crore, 2 crore, you know, that kind of money from a common man, it is his whole life savings. Now, I'm sure, compared to your Mr. Mangal Prabhat Lodha's 26,000 crore rupees, it's a drop in the ocean. But 50 lakh, 20 lakh, 10 lakh, even 5 lakhs. Aray, forget 5 lakhs here. For a guy who has just started earning even 25,000, 50,000 rupees, if it is forfeited, if it's taken away, it's a big deal. It hits him very hard. Ordinary middle class guy trying to have his own house, impulsively swipes his card. Okay, why impulsively? We'll get into that later. We have talked about it earlier. We'll get into that later again. People are losing their life savings to Lodha. So it's not just a rhetorical question. It's important. How much have we contributed to the well-being of India's richest politician, India's richest builder? Question. Now, another question. There are all kind of charges that Lodha imposes when at the time of giving possession, like it is not written in your agreement, nothing written in your registered agreement, but suddenly fairly substantial numbers, which we will talk about in a later video, substantial amounts suddenly pop up. Not mentioned in registered agreement, not mentioned in total consideration amount, but there are little things, BCAM and FCAM and etc., etc., all kind of etc.s which come up at the time of giving possession. Like, you want the possession, pay this amount. If you don't pay this amount, you don't get possession. That kind of thing, right? You don't get possession, we'll forfeit your whole thing. You have breached the registered agreement if you don't pay this amount, because our wordings are there somehow, and bam, I'm going to take away 10%, 15%. That's the way it presents itself. That's the way India's richest politicians, companies, Lodha Group, companies present themselves to the public. Okay. So how much of the 26,000 crores has been made by this route? These extra charges which are imposed after the 100% of the consideration has been paid. That's a question. Let's have some figures. And then there's a third question, and this one will come, this is of interest to rural India. You know, he's a politician, so bhai, he has to be answerable to rural India also. He's India's richest politician. So let's have some answers. Let's have some questions from rural India. So farmers of Thane, Dombivli, Panvel, etc. may want to ask Mr. Mangal Prabhat Lodha, how much money have you paid for the land that you and your companies have taken over from farmers? I would have used the word purchased, but sometimes it's a bit less than consensual. It is not exactly consensual. Like Mangal Prabhat might say, or Lodha company might say, we have purchased X amount of land, and the farmer may say, no, you have not purchased X, you have purchased only X divided by 2 amount of land. And the Lodha company say, no, that's not what the transfers, you know, that's not what the records say. The records say we have purchased X amount of land, you know, or 2X, whatever. So the question is, how much of your personal fortune, your huge land bank, comes from the farmers of Thane, Dombivli, Panvel, other places? I don't know about all your land banks. And how much has been paid for those lands? And how much money have you made from these lands? How much money has been made? How much of the 26,000 crores is an earning from these, which didn't enrich the farmers? But of course, Mangal Prabhat Lodha is a builder. That's not his job. It's not his job to enrich the farmers. But then he's also a politician. He's an MLA. So kind of it is his job, at least in the last 24 years, to kind of make sure that farmers don't get poorer. They may not get richer, but they shouldn't get poorer, right? So it is his. So let's ask this question. How much have these companies earned from these deals? How much have they spent in these deals? Like, have they spent 10 crores, 100 crores, 1,000 crores? How much money did they spend on this land bank? This massive land bank which Lodha earned. Now, The reason to ask is, on a year-by-year basis, as a builder, Lodha, Mangal Prabhat Lodha has amassed 750 crore rupees per year if you consider 35 years as a builder. And he has amassed about 1000 crores per year. Personal fortune, I am not talking about the company, I am not talking about what is this company's name, not Microsoft, Macrotech. Yeah, Macrotech. Lodha Developers Limited is now Macrotech. So, and we are not talking about that. We are talking about the personal fortune, because that was the report of in the Economic Times and all that. His personal fortune. Okay. So how much of these 1000 crore rupees per year comes out of these land dealings, and how much goes into these land dealings? Question. Another question. How many 100 crore rupees of this personal fortune come from premium amounts? Premium is paid on by for purchasing carpet area. FSI, for purchasing FSI. You have to, a builder has to pay it to municipal corporation, or he has to pay it to MMRDA. He has to pay it to the local planning body. For the FSI, how much premium amount has Mangal Prabhat Lodha earned by not paying premium? Because, well, he says that is not a carpet area, that is chhajja. Actually, he says to MMRDA, well, you know, he doesn't say it. Sorry, I have to correct myself. He doesn't say it. The architect of the company says it. So it's all at arm's length. So to MMRDA, they say this is chhajja. This is elevation feature. To flat owners, they say this is balcony. This is usable carpet. Okay. Now, naturally, they don't pay any premium for that so-called usable carpet. For elevation features, they are not required to pay. They are only required to pay on FSI. So, how many 100 crores have been saved by not giving premium to MMRDA on FSI, not giving premium to MCGM on FSI? How much is that? Question. This is a question to, I don't know. Should we ask the builder? Should we ask the legislator? Let's ask the legislator. Because we can't ask the builder. For the builder, it's private. But let's ask the legislator, the MLA, Mr. Mangal Prabhat Lodha, this question. Will some of you guys ask? Now there's one more question. Carpet area. People find, when their architects measure it, and this goes across projects, when architects measure the properties of Lodha Group, they find that the carpet area, strictly defined, is about 20 to 30% less than what they were led to believe. I don't know. I suppose some personal enrichment comes out of that. I don't know. It's worth asking. It's a question. Maybe it didn't enrich you. Let's ask. Now, I want to know one simple thing. If any other industry, like the airline industry, caused so many people to lose their shirt, caused so many people to lose lakhs of rupees as token amount, booking amount, or even crores of rupees, and then charged later on after the agreement and all that. So if so many people suffered so many losses in any other industry, I think there would have been a public outcry. Like if it was happening in airline industry, there would have been a public outcry. If the common man lost lakhs of rupees, I am just reckoning, okay, just an idea. It's a few thousand people every year, or is it a few lakh people every year who lose their money like this to the building industry and don't get even one square foot of value? They just lose their money, token amount gone, booking amount gone. Why? You could not pay more. You paid fines. You have to pay fines. You have to pay penal interest. Why? You are one day late. You are paying your bill one day late. You are paying that we demanded that you should pay before 30th June. You paid on 1st July. Pay 20,000 more. This is the kind of charges which the Lodha companies are charging. Others are also charging, of course. So, if this were any other industry, wouldn't there have been an outcry? Wouldn't people have raised a hue and cry that people are losing money, middle class, ordinary people are losing money? But no questions are raised. In the mainstream media, no questions at all. In the parliament, union, no questions. In state legislature, no questions. Opposition MPs, no questions at all. Ruling party MPs, of course, will not ask any question because he's one of them. Opposition MPs also don't ask questions. So there is only one thing, and that's silence. It's just business as usual. Everybody keeps silence. Shh, don't say a word. Don't say a word. Don't talk about this. Somebody's fault. That poor middle class guy who swiped his card. Why did he swipe his card? It is his mistake, no? Let him pay. He could not pay on 30th June. He paid on 1st July. Uska baap ka maal samajh ke rakha hai kya? Let him pay 20,000 fine. Let him pay penal interest. Let him pay administrative charges of Lodha. Let him pay. Somebody told him to pay his installment one day late. No. So let him pay. So there is no sympathy. There is no sympathy for the victims. No sympathy in the press. No sympathy in opposition. No sympathy anywhere. And in the meanwhile, every week, even now, hundreds of innocent, hard-working couples and families with children are being skillfully gathered in these sales offices and these conference offices, halls across Mumbai, across Thane. These are organized by India's wealthiest builder, Mangal Prabhat Lodha's companies, or by India's wealthiest politician, Mangal Prabhat Lodha's companies. This skillful sales staff, very well trained sales staff, they bring together all these people, and then a few people will swipe their token, and then after that people will be pressured to pay more and more towards the 10% booking amount very quickly. And this goes on with dozens of families. Out of those 100 families who come, or 100 or 200 families who come in every week, a dozen or two dozen families will purchase a flat in Lodha Palava, in Lodha Upper Thane, in Lodha World View, in Lodha Cuffe Parade, all those projects. And then some of these people will not be successful in paying the rest of the amount, and they'll back off. They'll lose their amounts, or they will pay. Say some of the things will be paid late, and then they start paying penal interest. And at the end, they will have to pay some more money before getting possession. This goes on. So, complete silence. Opposition is not asking. Media is not asking. I want to know from the flat buying public. Guys, do you have balls or not? Will you ask this question to this MLA who has been in the state legislature for 24 years? Will you ask him how he makes this 26,000 crore rupees personal fortune? How he has amassed it? Good night.